Hello to everybody. Here is Attilio Cavezzi from Italy. I have the pleasure and the honor to share with Giovanni Mosti, my friend, a video presentation about adjustable compression wraps in phlebology and lymphology. So, what I will do as a first speaker is to review some basic principles and literature about this possible adjuvant medical devices in phlebology and lymphology. This is my disclosure slide as a collaborator from Medi from time to time. So, if we look at what is the reason, what is the rationale of adjustable compression wraps in phlebology and lymphology, we should start with the idea that self-management is becoming more and more important within healthcare systems. Because anyway, patients have to take their own responsibility for political reasons, because we are getting more and more patients who are aged, and that means that we have a high demand for and use of prolonged and very complex healthcare. On the other side, we know from science that anyway, a well-informed patient can be of help in the self management of a lot of diseases, and especially ulcer, lymphedema, edema in general are very good candidates for this kind of self-management, because self-efficacy can become a central concept. On one side, we know that managing bandaging is not so easy for patients themselves, but even from the side of nurses, therapists, and doctors, bandaging can be a quite complex device to apply and to get the proper pressure. So, what could we do to improve this situation? Let's say there is a kind of midline between hosiery and bandages. We can call it Velcro compression wraps or adjustable compression wraps. This is a key concept to focus on the self-management compression by means of these adjustable devices, because patients themselves can take care of this compression at home. And that is the case in lymphedema, in venous leg ulcer, and also, of course, in chronic edema. Which is the idea behind Velcro? Well, let's say that adjustable inelastic compression garments can be, of course, very useful for the treatment of several venous and lymphatic disease, and could be this idea a kind of alternative to short stretch and multi-layer bandage, which have proven to be absolutely interesting in a lot of venous and lymphatic disease, but with some limitations, as we told before. This is a kind of alternative, especially for people also who cannot wear classical stockings or classical sleeves, or we can combine with stockings. But especially, as I told you, it is a very good idea for self-management of whichever disease which can be treated by compression in veins and lymphatics. The BPS system has been realized and patented to, it is the acronym for built-in pressure system. It is a patent technology. Well, it is a support to get the correct therapeutic level of compression. So every patient can very easily understand and learn how to get the proper pressure when applying Circade and when applying adjustable compression wraps. So, when we talk about compression, we know about the importance of inelastic or low elasticity material. Regrettably, there are very few randomized controlled trials on the effectiveness of adjustable compression wraps. But what we know is that adjustable compression wraps exert about the same pressure as inelastic bandages, which is very important when we look for a high interface pressure dealing with ulcer, edema, and so on and so on. That means good pressure, especially when the patient is walking, is moving. If we go for a kind of an elaboration on the similarities and the differences between adjustable compression wraps, stockings, and bandages, you see that as to pressure, ACW are as good as bandages, and better than stockings. They have a very good stiffness, very similar to bandages, of course, and their effectiveness from the hemodynamic point of view is very good. But, and this is a major, major point to take into account, adjustable compression wrap may have a very good pressure which is maintained over time. And last but not least, in terms of self-management, an expert personnel is not required when you use an adjustable compression wraps. Just for example, in this study from Mosty and Parch, in these studies, in fact, they somehow demonstrated that the supine pressure, when the patients were educated to apply the ACW, basically they absolutely achieved the correct pressure with this device. And this is another article from Hugo Parch, which was recently published in Phlebology. And you see here that giving a couple of courses, the nurses were very good in applying a very high average pressure, you see 61.5 millimeter of mercury, when using adjustable compression wraps. So it's not difficult at all. Let's have a look at what literature offers us in terms of data for adjustable compression wraps, for example, in edema, venous edema. In this article we published a few years ago, as you can see, we compare inelastic bandage with adjustable compression wraps circade. And you see that the percentage of edema reduction after one day is higher for circade over bandage. And after 1 week, it's even higher, as you can see here, for circade in comparison to bandage. Then, if you look at the pressure, you see that the bandage, regrettably, in supine position, the pressure goes down after 1 day. That's not the case. You see here, that's not the case after 1 day when you use circade. The pressure is very well maintained after 1 day. When we talk about the pressure in standing position, exactly the same time. The pressure, which was decided around 50 millimeter of mercury, is maintained as it is after 1 day, even in standing position. This is another study from Jean-Patrick Benigny, Uhul, and other friends from France, where they demonstrated, for example, that when you use in poorly mobile nursing home patients adjustable compression wraps circade alone, that's the blue one, you get better edema reduction than in comparison with circade followed by compression garments. So circade is better in terms of edema reduction again. Let's have a look at lymphedema. What do we have from literature? This elegant study from Damsra and Parch assessed the differences between, again, Velcro wraps circade, JustaFit, versus inelastic bandages. This is the comparison for the patients with the lower limb lymphedema. So in terms of leg volumes, you see very clearly that after 2 hours and after 24 hours, there is a clear, better reduction of volume when using JustaFit in comparison to a tricho bandaging, and the difference is statistically significant. And if you look at the interface pressure, which is also another very important item to keep into consideration, again, the pressure loss after 2 hours is much higher for bandaging, and it is the same, it is much higher for bandaging in comparison to JustaFit after 24 hours. And again, what they measure, and this is also very interesting, is the self-management of this device. And as you can see here, basically the medical staff and patient, when applying this device, were able to confirm the pressure, to achieve the pressure which was needed. So the self-management was somehow very well demonstrated in that article. This is another article where basically they compared again inelastic bandage, multi-layer bandages with adjustable compression wraps, and their final results were that there was no significant difference regarding excess volume or symptoms between adjustable compression wraps and multi-layer compression bandages. This is another article which was published just less than 1 year ago. Now let's move to ulcer. Well, about ulcers, we have not so much literature. This is a very old study where you can clearly see that circade group performed a little bit better than bandaging group. So in terms of ulcer area reduction rate and in terms of edema reduction and patient satisfaction score, Circade performed better than bandaging, and the difference was statistically significant. If we have a look at this very nice review on adjustable Velcro wrap devices for venous ulceration, they basically, going through literature, could not demonstrate so much. So basically, their conclusion was that it is interesting to treat patients with ulcer with adjustable compression wraps in terms of costs, which is very important, nursing time, patient satisfaction, and potentially ulcer healing. But they suggested somehow to have a higher quality studies such as a randomized controlled trial in ulcer healing treated with adjustable compression wraps. And that's when the work from Giovanni Mosti and collaborators came. As Giovanni will show you in the following presentation, this very elegant study, a multi-center Italian randomized clinical experience, he will explain how adjustable compression wraps perform in ulcers, in venous ulcer of the lower limb. So which are my main conclusions? On one side, Circade devices can be safely used in phlebology and lymphology, and there is no requirement for an expert personnel to be applied. The comparison with inelastic bandage basically seems to increase the ulcer healing rate and to treat edema and lymphedema slightly better in comparison to inelastic bandage. And also, the device is well tolerated. So at the end of the day, I want to thank absolutely Ugo Parch and Giovanni Mosti for their great work and help. And especially, you will listen now and see Giovanni following about this possibility, which we should take in consideration because of cost, because of efficacy, safety, which are three very interesting parameters when you want to, let's say, take care of venous and lymphatic disease. Thank you very much.
Hello, everybody. I'm Giovanni Mosti from Lucca, Italy, and together with Attilio, we hope that in this sad period of lockdown, we will be able, at least in this short period of our presentation, to make you feel closer to a normal life when we need to face with the daily activity, with the daily working activity. Today, I will speak with you about adjustable compression wraps in venous ulcers. This is our disclosure. And I want to start from guidelines because I want to show you that almost all guidelines recommend a strong compression pressure when dealing with venous ulcers. And the reason why we need a strong compression is very clear if we remember the venous pathophysiology. When we have a venous disease, the normal decrease of intravenous pressure doesn't happen anymore, but the pressure decrease is very low. You see here in this case from 80 millimeter of mercury, the pressure decreases just to 70 millimeter of mercury. And this pressure, intravenous pressure, can even increase in case of venous obstruction, leading to ambulatory venous hypertension, capillary hypertension, fluid extravasation, hypoxia, skin changes, and finally ulcers. So if we remind all these, we certainly understand why just an inelastic device, in this case an inelastic bandage, able to overcome the intravenous pressure that is fluctuating between 70 and 80 millimeter of mercury, even in during walking, only an inelastic device able to overcome this intravenous pressure is able to occlude the veins, providing a kind of valve mechanism, because in this case, for instance, the patient is doing just some foot dorsiflexion, and you see that even doing this in supine position, the intravenous pressure is overcome, and then the patient stands up, and again, there is a huge increase of external pressure overcoming the intravenous pressure, and when the patient walks again, the external pressure is able to overcome the intravenous pressure, so occluding the veins and providing a kind of valve mechanism, restoring a kind of valve mechanism that was lost because of the venous disease. This is possible with adjustable compression wrap, which you see here a circuit just a cure, doing exactly the same during foot dorsiflexion, during walking, while standing up, the pressure is able to overcome the intravenous pressure, the pressure provided by the external compression, and overcome the intravenous pressure and restore a kind of our mechanism. And this is not possible with elastic material. You see here an elastic bandage and an elastic stocking. They have more or less the same behavior, a little bit difference of pressure, but same behavior. And look what happens when applying an elastic compression, an elastic bandage, at the same pressure of an inelastic compression and an inelastic device. You see here that due to the very low stiffness, the elastic material is not able to overcome the intravenous pressure, so no chance to occlude the veins and to restore a kind of valve mechanism, and this was not possible neither with the elastic bandage or with the elastic stocking. So it is important to recognize that only in elastic material, multi-layer, multi-component bandages and or adjustable compression wraps can provide effectiveness and at the same time comfort, because they are able to exert a very strong standing pressure and pressure peaks that are effective in counteracting ambulatory venous hypertension, starting from a much lower and comfortable supine pressure. So I would conclude that inelastic material must be preferred in ulcer treatment. And actually, when you compare elastic and inelastic material from a hemodynamic point of view, you can realize that inelastic material is significantly more effective in decreasing venous reflux, increasing venous pumping function, and obviously more effective in reducing ambulatory venous hypertension. But if this is true, why we have so many reports on a superior or similar effect of elastic kits or elastic stocking when compared with elastic bandages in venous ulcer treatment? Because unfortunately, a lot of these papers have a lot of methodological flaws. First of all, compression pressure that represents the dosage of compression is not measured, and what kind of pressure is unknown. The level of expertise of healthcare professional is unknown, and we will see in a few slides how these two points are very important. What kind of inelastic bandage was used, and the adherence to treatment of the patient is also unknown, and sometimes patients were allowed to remove and reapply the bandage by themselves. In addition, in these comparative papers, not an elastic stocking, but an elastic kit made up of two superimposed stocking was used, and this material is able to exert about 40 millimeter of mercury at rest, and it can well happen that a good elastic kit was more effective than a poorly applied inelastic bandage. When compression is measured and inelastic material is correctly applied, inelastic compression is very effective and more effective than elastic stockings. But unfortunately, we have very few reports on this. By using inelastic bandages, we have two critical issues. First of all, pressure falls down over time due to leg volume decrease. We have an edema reduction, a significant edema reduction with this material, and by reducing the volume of the leg, the pressure decreases, and the other reason is the material fatigue. This pressure fall is not very important because, as we've shown in 2010, inelastic material is able to maintain the hemodynamic effect despite of the pressure loss. But much more important is that the application of inelastic bandages require proper education, because contrarily to what a lot of people think, the pressure is not in the bandage, but it is in our hands, and it is dependent on our ability in applying the correct tension to the bandage and correctly wrap the bandage around the leg, overlapping correctly the turns. If we look at this publication, it is very interesting. It was published in 2014 by Kerstin Protz and colleagues. You see that they gave 551 expert personnel. There were expert nurses used to apply inelastic bandages every day. They gave them an inelastic bandage able to provide, to exert the pressure of 50-60 millimeter mercury when correctly applied. This is the correct application. But look what happened. This personnel, the huge number of personnel, applied a compression pressure very variable, between a little bit more than zero to more than 140 millimeter of mercury. And if you look more specifically, 17% of this personnel applied a very strong pressure, in average 80 millimeter mercury, but in some cases more than 140, that it is an amazing strong pressure, certainly painful. Only 10% of this personnel was able to apply the correct pressure, and the great majority, 76%, applied a very low pressure, in average 30 millimeter mercury, but starting even from a little bit more than zero. So if you remind the comparison we saw before, you can easily understand that if an elastic kit was compared with an inelastic bandage applied in this way, it is absolutely clear that an elastic kit is more effective than an inelastic bandage applied so poorly. So I would say that venous legalcia treatment requires not only a strong compression, at least 40 millimeter mercury, but also devices simultaneously exerting strong compression, but easy to apply. And adjustable compression wraps certainly correspond to this requirement. Adjustable compression wraps, but I would say circade, because all the data come from studies performed with a circade. We don't have any other scientific report with other kind of adjustable compression wraps. Circade was shown to be effective in self-management, edema treatment, lymphedema treatment, and venous ulcer treatment. Regarding venous ulcers, we don't have many reports. There is a very old one published in 1999 from De Palma and co-workers. They reported that treatment of venous ulcer with circade is significantly less expensive than treatment with the traditional Luna boots, and they were mainly focused on costs, but they were also able to show a trend toward faster healing with a circade. This is a very important study, very nice study, because Black and Villa Vicencio in 2005 used a very interesting experimental model, because they examined 12 patients with bilateral post-thrombotic venous leg ulcers. So in 24 extremities, they could apply in one leg an inelastic bandage and in the other leg the circade. And you can see here that despite of the same patient, about the same ulcer, exactly the same pathophysiology, adjustable compression wraps, a circade, was able to show a faster healing rate when compared with the inelastic bandage. In Italy, we performed a study involving six centers and enrolling 66 patients, 11 per center. The compression device is a circade in 33 patients and Coban 2L in 33 patients. In order to minimize all the possible variables, we use the same ulcer debridement by UCS, the same dressing. We didn't allow any changes of the systemic treatment. No additional drug or intervention was allowed. No vein treatment in the 12 weeks of the study. Sample size was again calculated to assess potential cost savings. So primary outcomes were costs, self-management of compression devices, ulcer area change, and well-being questionnaire. And only as secondary outcome, daily rate after 12 weeks. From a methodological point of view, we try to visit our patient just once per week, performing the wound cleansing, the bandage and dressing change, and wound measurement. Of course, patients in the circuit group were requested to readjust the pressure when feeling loose, while patients in the common to air group needed nurses or doctors' assistance to remove and apply the bandage. From material cost point of view, no way. Obviously, the circuit is much more cheap than an elastic bandage because the same device can be used and reused every time. And in the other case, you need to throw away the disposable inelastic material. But you need to know that we have additional cost savings because in the clinical practice, you can imagine that dressing changes are necessary more than once per week, and this would increase the cost of the common tool that it is disposable or an elastic bandage. And in a way, while with the circuit, we can reuse always the same material. The ulcer patient who were not healed after 12 weeks obviously will need new bandages, while the circuit patient could keep their compression device. And material is not the only factor contributing to total cost, because if you imagine that you can self-readjust and self-manage the ulcer, and you can save expert personnel intervention, and you certainly know that expert personnel costs is much more than material costs. So you can really save a lot of money. Coming to ulcer healing rate, it was higher, as you can see here, with circuit with compared with the inelastic material, but the sample size was not calculated for healing rate, so we didn't get a significant difference in this regard. Looking at ulcer surface reduction, the ulcer surface reduction also was higher in the circuit group compared to inelastic bandage group. And this is the reason why I think we get better results with circuit, because we measure the pressure, the compression pressure, not only at application but also at removal. And you can see here that when using circuit, the compression pressure at removal was about the same and even higher than the compression pressure at application. You see here 48, 49. While when using inelastic material, you have a significant pressure drop. It was applied about the same pressure as circuit, but you can see here that at removal, the pressure is significantly decreased. And this is, I think, the reason why circuit was more effective despite of a lower stiffness. Coming to comfort, a side effect, for many aspects, circuit was more effective than common 2L, also significantly more effective, but I would say that both the devices are comfortable and the side effects are really. In conclusion, inelastic material has to be preferred in case of venous ulcer treatment by using effective but easy to apply materials. Adjustable compression wraps are very effective in venous ulcer treatment, in addition to their effectiveness in edema and lymphedema treatment. And their effectiveness compared to inelastic bandages seems to depend more on pressure maintenance than on stiffness. Self-management would increase patients' adherence to treatment and certainly allow us cost savings. And last but not least, circuit is very nicely tolerated and does not cause unwanted effect. And finally, I would like to say that since the time of Achilles and Patroclus wrapped cotton bandages around their wounded legs, we certainly have an amazing treatment advanced at current time by adjustable compression wraps and specifically circuit. I would like to thank you all for your kind attention and for your patience.